In this podcast, we would like to present to you the most important new features in EDIUS 8.51. Let's start with the new features in Mink. In Mink, it is now possible to add background music to a storyboard. To do this, you first have to add a music clip to the storyboard. Simply drag and drop the clips into the storyboard folder. Above the storyboard, the number of still images, video and music clips your storyboard contains are displayed. Open the storyboard settings. Under the Volume tab, you can set the volume for the whole storyboard or for the video and music only. If you want the music in your storyboard to fade in or out, simply set the appropriate value. Under Music Settings, you can specify more details for your background music. For example, set 10 seconds of offset if you want your music to start 10 seconds into the storyboard. The interval sets the breaks between the music clips in case you have added more than one clip. If you want the background music to play in a loop, simply activate the Repeat option. The music will be played according to their order in the list. You can change the order via drag and drop. Right-click on a music clip to duplicate or delete it from the storyboard. Below the preview, the music is represented by a yellow line. This allows you to easily see in which area of your storyboard you have added background music. Click on the play button to listen to the result. Please note that it is not possible to change the duration of your music clips within Mink. Another new feature in Mink lets you delete imported histories. To do so, right-click on an imported history and choose Delete. If you delete the history, the clips will remain on your hard drive, but only the information in Mink will be deleted. One new feature in version 8.51 is only available in EDIUS Workgroup, the loudness auto-correction, that normalizes the loudness automatically. Go to File, Export, Print to File. Open the Advanced Settings and activate the option Normalize Loudness. Choose the EBU R128 standard and export your film. A third important new feature affects the display of font sizes in the Quick Titler. A new title format was implemented. Whenever the DPI size of the screen is changed in Windows, the size of the font in Quick Titler changes as well. Until now, this has led to some problems when a project has been worked on with various screens with different DPI settings. With the new title format, the font size stays the same, independent of the DPI setting. If you create a new title and save it with Save As, you can choose between the old format, .etl, and the new format, .etl2. If you want to edit a title which was created previously, you will be asked if you want to open it in the new format. Since the new title format also uses a new render engine, the new title varies in appearance somewhat from the older one. Please note that even if a title is used several times within a project or in different projects, every single title clip has to be saved individually in the new format. Click here for the next podcast. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. Visit EDIUS.NET for more information about EDIUS, plugins, tutorials, and the latest downloads.